Daily Cafe starts right now.
Anyway, Fred, you're going to like this because our next guest is establishing himself as the most imaginative maestro of his generation. Carlo Ponti, son of Sophia Loren, is releasing his debut album, that's Mussorgsky's Pictures at an Exhibition, and we're so glad to have you. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
I should also say you're the son of your namesake, Carlo Ponti, as
that's
well.
Right.
That's right.
We had
to
take it
to Carlo Ponti Sr., who really had a tremendous influence in bringing you to where you are today because he recognized your talent as a child, didn't he?
Yes, he did recognize my talent, and I think that I'm a conductor to this day because he really, you know, put me in that direction. So,
you listened to Brahms and Beethoven growing up. I mean, what was it that put you at the piano and playing on the keyboard and developing your love of music?
Well, music was always playing in our house, and my parents were very, you know, loved music, absolutely. But I must say that they never really pushed me, you know, to do something specific. I mean, they really left it up to me to really choose something. So, mm-hmm. so I'm very grateful of that.
And before we get to you, certainly our audience is notably going to be very big fans of your parents. What was that like growing up in such a perceived to be glamorous household, such talent?
Well, it was something that I never felt because my parents were so down to earth, really. And so I never felt that they were so famous. And to this day, I'm actually surprised of having such a legendary, you know,
really?
Mother, actually.
Yeah, but you appreciate
father.
Her legend, I mean, don't you? I mean,
absolutely.
She is enormous.
Absolutely.
I mean, you can't
absolutely.
Go anywhere in this world nearly without somebody knowing her for her talent and her remarkable beauty, which obviously passes down. There we go. The generationals, there we go. All right, let's get to you as a conductor. What took you from loving music and playing it to believing that you could be the maestro and organizing it and conducting it and running it?
Well, it's something that was very developmental, I think. I was a pianist mm-hmm. by trade. And although when I played piano, I never felt quite at home on the stage, and whereas when I conduct, I really feel at home, and it's something that I can really make work, you know, mm-hmm. and I like it very much. So.
And the San Bernardino Orchestra there, that is just about 60 miles or so east of Los Angeles, for those who don't know it. You have an audience there of what type of people? Do you have a lot of young people, or is it predominantly older people?
We have a mix, pretty much. We're seeing much more young people come in
That's
the
great.
Audience right now.
That's great. Do you think you
and
have a part to do with that? I mean, in all honesty.
Well, I think that we program, you know, very accessible pieces, and I think that helped a lot. And I also work closely with the schools in the area. Mm-hmm. So I think that really played a big part in.
Well, we wish you continued success. There's the maestro there. You'll probably leap from the San Bernardino Orchestra to somewhere else at some point. We'll be talking about you. But meantime, we wish you very good luck with Pictures at an Exhibition,
thank
your
you so
debut
much for the
album.
Time.
Thank you so
thank
much.
You.
Good
thank
to meet you, too.
Thank you.
What do you think, Fred? We have a maestro in our midst.
Fascinating stuff. I mean, the discipline that goes into just playing an instrument, let alone conducting an entire orchestra,
I know.
Is
I
even
know.
More than I can fathom.
I know, because you just think of all the different sounds that are playing in your head, and you have to keep track of so much at one time. Talented guy there.
That's right.